Welcome to Factory Modded. This is SpaceX K2. I am flying the potato with my wiggle train. I was doing some fun things offline. Well, not offline, online last time. I managed to get the train going around. I don't know whether that's supposed to be a thing, but I was having fun with it anyway. I need to dock it again. I don't know where I'm supposed to dock this thing. I think it's like over here somewhere. There's like a pump. I don't know where it's actually supposed to hook in. Doesn't particularly matter. Oh, it goes there. Oh, I see. Yeah. So I was gonna make the this shipper do something. But I don't know. I was just playing around, so I just might just leave it be. We'll carry on doing Maelstrom. I feel like just ripping the whole planet up, to be honest. I don't think matters. I reckon there's biter meteors in this planet. I don't know whether these biters have showed up or not. I know there's a bit of a problem with these. I think the biter meteors, they're supposed to be on no chance if I got this many of these things. I got so many of these. I got heaps. Where's the number? Can't tell, it's not showing. Maybe it's showing, but I can't see it. But I got lots of them. So lots of cannons. But the binders shouldn't be able to arrive. So I got vitamin lunch here. And iron. Actually quite a nice combo. I could actually create quite a big base if I wanted to, but haven't been motivated so far. I'm actually kind of leaning towards grabbing that one core miner and being done with it. I mean, I could go down to south, there's three around the center. I also have a train line going all the way down here too, and I ripped it all up. I have power lines, rope ports, everything, and I got rid of it all because I was like, gonna wrap this planet up and do core mining. But then the optimization changed. Now I need it again. So maybe we'll just grab. I mean, that's not. That one's so far away. That one's kind of close. I mean, one's probably fine. This planet's kind of chunky, right? So I don't really need the actual resource. It's just turning to matter. So this thing here. Wouldn't be too bad. I do like that setup as well. So we kind of want this. On Maelstrom. I don't know where I'll put it. I mean, I could just put it right down here. I do long train lines, maybe that's fine. I mean, we could dock to the right, I guess. Well, these are the wrong way around, though. Oh, yeah. You have to do it that way. That's kind of frustrating. I can do it in two pieces though. Hey Goblin. Nice to see you here. Long time no see. Been years, mate. It's been years. Haven't seen you in a long time. Millennia, yeah, millennia. True story, man, true story. Alright, that shouldn't be too hard to build. So the bots should go down there and do their thing. And we can just The only thing I need is the radar down there. Might need a bit of radar. And then we can send, my spaceship. I do have a spaceship. Currently doesn't dock. I don't know where the docking clamp went. We used to have a docking clamp on this planet, but I don't think it's in use anymore. Ships used to dock. Yeah, there's no docking clamp. So I don't know what I did with it, but it's gone. It's unfortunate, but that's fine. I'm gonna go Ixion. This is supposed to be bringing copper cores. But maybe just don't use me in them. Got two of them hooked up. I mean, last time I was kind of mucking around on Maelstrom, I was, wasn't doing anything productive. Doesn't particularly matter which one I pick. I might as well pick the middle ones though, because then I can, do it nicer. Yeah. Oh, the bots are coming down. They're building. They're slowly growing the little network. What do I need to do anything else about the network? I could give them a buffer chest. I used to do that, but I gotta probably find my iron core ship, the Radjack. I'm only sitting in orbit and I got no cargo rocket sections. Oh. Oh, we've filled it up without. Oh. My logic failed. These are supposed to be off. They filled it up. Well, that's awkward. Alright, let's do this. Should be blacklist, cargo sections. There we go. Wonder how that happened. One of these other ones are stuck. There's like a legacy one. These others look fine. Now I do have a, I had a copper one as well, but it's just sort of sitting here, and the ship's not going. Oh, it's got this old logic. It doesn't go back unless I run out. So the ground has already got 14,000. Yeah, it's obviously not processing it very well, or very fast. I should say. I haven't really laid this out better. I should really do that. So it will process it. So this is the copper here. And mostly it's not going anywhere. I don't believe we have much need for that copper. Very slowly getting used. So I didn't actually really need the core mining for copper. Now the iron core looks like the Radjack will be in use, so we might be alright for that. Filled it up quite well. How's this going? Alright, so it's going back. Okay. I don't know where this one goes to. Where's the Radjack go to? Ophion. Oh. Oh man, I'm so forgetful. I went to the whole effort of getting another whole entire iron ore core mining planet and I totally forgot about it. This is another one that I got Actually, it's probably better than what I was just setting up. Looks like it's a bit flooded though with bots. We got 1300 bots. I wonder if they need logic for this as well, which was this one. I can move these out of the way. That'll do. I think it's quite a good blueprint actually doing that. I still haven't done my planet logic where it counts and then junks. Maybe I can work on the junking. So if I get some junk logic, I can paste it to every surface. And then I'll slowly clean up every planet of items. There's a lot of items that sit around, like all this stuff sits around. I don't need it. Anything on the shopping list should stay. Anything else should go. Should I stay or should I go now? Should I stay or should I go now? Try. Get some erudite. We get some more cores. I've got two of them. I don't think of that much though. We get 22 from two of them. It's pretty little. We've got these old chests set up here. What's the mystery, Goldman? What's the great mystery? How many of these are there? 24. Where are they right? There's a ship. Load up very quickly. Everything is a mystery. Oh. We're gonna get another. I can get some more coal miners here, I think. I don't really need to. I just feel like I should do. Otherwise, we could actually process it here. Like, would I want to process iron ore core fragments off world? My brain says a big no. I would probably not decentralize that. This is like a huge mining patch though. I don't think I've seen one this big. It's monstrous. And we've got some erudite here as well, but I ain't got oil, so I could actually go and mine it. Not really interested though. Get this, these other cores, though. Not the worst setup. What's the other one? This one over here. The power poles. Why does that have alignment? That's weird. We're low on reports. Yeah. Oh. Okie dokie. Maybe I don't request them. I thought I did. I thought it was part of my list here. Got 40 of them. This is filled up with crap. I haven't figured that out yet. I could change these to be buffer chests. Then it wouldn't work because they require requesting from a buffer chest. So I'm not sure what logic chain to use. I mean, I could belt them out. I don't think that's a good idea. Anyway, this should mean I get other items. Oh, we got a bannable offense. Where's my chat these days? Oh, I got two lots of them. What do I got? Why do they target like? They like coming like little pack, like little pack animals. Well, that's about. Okay, whatever. Buffers. Yep. Right, that's that one. This one should be easy enough. What are they? They should not be passive warehouses. There should be steel wet chests. There we go. What? Power lines. You have to wait. That's okay. Well, we can't go there. It's probably the top of the spaceship. Can't quite tell where the spaceship goes. There we go. I think one of these. Oh, maybe I do a bridging one. Give it to both sides. That'd be fine. I don't think I need to do more than that. I probably can abandon that planet then. There's lots of resources there, but I don't know the reason why I'd stick around, unless I want a better version of the core mining. So this core mining is really bad. Basically, I have to get all the cores, and it'd still be shit. You have to cover the whole planet in cores, which is not much fun. Whereas if I use Maelstrom for core mining, I wouldn't need too many of them. So I got one. Well, I thought I had one, it hasn't built it. Bit sad, why not? I guess we got problems with the robot's coverage. But no pylon substations, really. Huh. Kind of important. That'll be fine. What's the robot network like? We got 400 bots. That's not too bad. I can live with that. Need the coal miner though. I thought we made them. It says we're gonna make 16.5 a second. It's just heaps. That's more than the 4 on the other planet. So we need to make generic many more. Here we go. Got no electric mining, really. Did they die or something? What's happened? No, they're definitely there. We got 10 buffer, that's the problem. That needs electric mining drill too. Oh. Really? This needs to drive. Oh, I don't even make them. Okay. That's missing from my. Oh, my build order. It doesn't exist. So you need this one. This one here is like. I don't know. I haven't built that one. It's like a smaller mining area, but mines faster. And it's smaller as well, footprint wise, so maybe it is better. You can fit more in. But I don't know, I haven't actually built it. I need another miner for the other thing. Now this is also lacking inserters, so obviously that changed too. It needs blue inserters, which we don't make here. This whole belt chain changed. I haven't redone it for every planet. Might be time to redesign this whole belt in the back. Well, it's like a delivery cannon base. I really like the idea. I really like the concept of it. I could start doing from scratch. Went to the ring currently. It's like a lot of extra stuff left over. Because we need the burner inserters, which is the problem of this setup. We just need these. We just need motors, which I don't have. And then the yellows below it. Doesn't need that one. Just needs him. So that's the burners. This is now gonna become yellows. That needs those AI cores. Doesn't really fit in there, does it? I'm gonna rip that out. Oh, think about it. It'd work there, I think. Maybe. We can have a belt of burners, that's not the end of the world. This is going to be AI cores. Is that cores? AI cores? Or is it something else? I think it's in this tree. Yeah, automation cores, that's the one. Less than 20. Might swap that to being a buffer chest as well rather than a requester. So we can request from it. And then we can put this into this one. Bit much. That's fine. Get 10 output. Maybe a bit low. Snow electric engines? Is that a thing? What died? Copper wire died. What happened to copper wire? No copper? That's just a problem. The belt's got no copper coming on it. And copper's arriving slowly, but you have to reimagine this whole thing. I mean, I laid it out quite well when I did it at the time. I thought it was quite a good design, but things have changed. I mean, I could just lay it out like in a grid, like in rows and stuff, but I kind of had it so that most of it was belted instead of fed, so that they kind of feed each other before they need to go to the bot network. I mean, this is not really getting. I mean, it's still gonna get them. Don't need that. But I think they're like the blue inserters, green, yellow, whatever. These blue inserters now are a bit tricky. I mean, look at those requests over the top, I think. Doesn't need a lot of inserting parts, actually. Quite surprised. I don't know if the size is broken or not. It looks a bit sad. It's probably just an equitite. Alright, we'll just downgrade these initially. So I can get made. We're gonna lay this out better with space limitations as well. I'm gonna check on now this orbit. We should do a science one. Like here, make a pin. A bit lazier pins. Science. Icons of science. Is there a disco ball? I mean, what say science? Sure. All right, it's fine. There we go. So Deep Space Science back to, which is what I thought. That's okay though, we can work with that. So we got the production going again. We don't need that one, I guess. That one can go. We've got some inserters. Now the money mark twos. We need that. Need that mark two drills. Looks like we're good to make them, so. Let's have the inserters. We're a bit low on the ingredients. Hey Rigathian. Wait, how come you've got a research server on land? I don't know, it's been there for like a long time. I guess I could do science down here then. Look at that, it's hooks on with things. That's funny. Didn't realize I swapped it to, this used to do the K2 research. I guess they made it so you can't do that so well. I probably should delay today. It's a leftover from olden times. This base is very old. I'm just trying to figure out making a better Dittery cannon base for a 0.7 playthrough. But you can't really prep for a 0.7 playthrough, but you can, I guess, do the maul items, and they won't change too much. So, I'd like to make this more efficient. It's not too bad, a layout, but definitely could do some work. We're running, we shouldn't have any, stack inserters available. Oh, Rigathian, have you tried using pyroflux in your flamethrowers? Apparently that's a thing. Oh, we got a raid. Welcome, 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 raiders. How's it going, SF Hoppet? Thanks for the raid. How goes you? I think I saw you on earlier. I didn't stick around though, but yeah, we're playing Factorio. I see. How's your Factorio going? What's the way forward of Factorio with Hobbit? Was just knocking out achievements. Oh, nice. What, just like, vanilla achievements? We got the, we tried the milestones mod. Apparently that's pretty cool. I haven't got it myself, but apparently it's quite good for SpaceX. You see what you got outstanding to do. Andy Gaming, how's it going? Haven't tried any mods yet. Finishing a cheese fest. Oh, nice. I've only got 30 out of 38 achievements, so you probably got more achieves than me. It might keep getting reset whenever I go and join someone's multiplayer game. Have you got the 8-hour achievement? The There Is No Spoon or whatever it's called? I was trying to do that solo once upon a time, but that was in like 0.16. I can only do 11 hours solo. I was too slow. That was like, you know, default resources and everything. Eight hours is easy? Oh, okay. That's cool. Did you use a multiplayer game of it, or just your own print, or standard resources, or did you buffer it right up? It can make a big difference, depending on what you do. Why are these not going? Actually, I think they've been turned off. There's no requests in these, though. Oh, there's no copper available. I see. No, solid game. Adjust the resources, though. You need to have big fields so you don't have to go trains. Makes them much shorter. Oh, okay, that's cool. Yeah, I had trains in my attempt. I got this. I got the 15-hour achieve, but I couldn't get the 8-hour. It was too hard. That was like 5 years ago since I tried that. I've pondered doing some speedrun type things just to get better at the game, but I find it quite stressful. But so, what's the hardest achievement you reckon of your last two? What's the hard one left? Hard two left. Oh, we got red inserters. Oh, it actually needs those. Oh, that's weird. Just random requests. I don't think we need all that. Might do more of a constant combinator though. 20 million green circuits, but I haven't really played Megabase yet. I tend to keep restarting after I launch Rocket or Dozen. So does that 20... Is that 20 million green circuits in one game? I mean, is there a way to show... How do you show achievements when you're playing? Is there a way of doing it? I have no idea. I mean, do you just... Is there a... I have no idea. Top right. Oh, this thing. Ah. I see, I see. So, that's a 513,000. I see. But I don't have many green circuits. I failed all these ones. Damn it. I would like to see how you do, what, 20 hours? What's this faster than light? I think there's a K2 achievement. I would like to see someone do K2 under 20 hours, actually. It's quite tricky. I find K2 not the easiest mod. It's a lot more difficult than the normal factory. I would recommend it, though. It's quite a good, stepping stone mod. Might move these out of the way. I don't think these should be here. Faster than light is just nuts in K2EC. Yeah, that doesn't seem possible, eh? Yeah, planning to check it out eventually. Oh yeah, cool. So that's my favourite thing of K2 is these greenhouses. I like the idea of growing trees. It's technically not free, I guess, but it's kind of I kind of like it. 20 hours doable in K2SC? I don't think so. I even with like full blueprints, I don't think that's possible. You'd have to like have perfect prints at every step, pacing down. And even then, you're gonna get gated on the the necrotite finding that, and then mining it and shipping it. So there's shipping distances and stuff. It takes hours to get enough necrotite to do anything. Literally hundreds of hours. I mean, I spent ages getting that going. Oh, what are we doing down here now? Are we moving it down there? Okay, we don't really want to do that. 30 second, that's pretty good core fragments from one. You can shortcut that by sending cargo rockets. Oh yeah, that's true. I actually did do Naquatite rockets at this base here. Where was it? I ripped it up, I think. I think it was in here. That's the Naquatite here. There's a trains for it, but they kind of a bit dead, looks like. What's happened? We finally run out? I think we ran out of Naquatite. Yeah, I think you need like 20 or 30 million Naquatite if you don't make productivity out of it to win. So you need like at least 3 or 4 good patches. Like, you know, big patches. But that's one, that's the only reason I know that is because I'm doing chat plays Factorio. Looks like this is like I should retire this planet, this outpost. This is like very old. I did set, hey, what's this? It's got a different icon. Look at this, it's got a little purple thing. This is like, it doesn't make gas, you see. So I suppose we're doing this biosludge to methane. My biosludge to methane to oil. I was testing it out here, but I never really did much of it. This is before you needed like methane ice in general. This is an old base. I got lots of things like this like flowing around my game because I always services, like there's the services. Everywhere there's a not just a person icon, there's buildings, so all down to there is all, I got things in all those places. But mostly it's just like, you know, very small bases. Well, this one here is just like an asteroid field. And all it's doing is tech cards. And I used to rocket this. But I got rid of the rocket. Rocket doesn't do anything anymore. And now I pick it up with my spaceship. But I also got a barrels here. I think I was filling them out. I don't know. Doesn't look too hospitable. Now this is like just getting flooded with uranium, it looks like. I gotta make my bots like not do so much work though. I've kind of I was trying to do like efficient decentralization where the rockets drop on a landing pad, are processed next to the landing pad, and then the resource gets belted to where it needs to be. But I think my layout's not very done very well, so I could probably plan a nicer one where you've got all 14 core fragments to process in like a grid. And then I have like either trains or belts coming off that area. Cause I can just move like the pads, the pads don't have to be physically where they are, I can move them anytime. It's got like 2 core processors and a pad. So these are little setups for each resource. That's rare metals. That's crystals. This is coal. Like some of them don't even have their own rocket pad. I was doing this to one rocket pad for a while. So I have to split it out so they get their own rocket pad. This generic one. They all kind of share. Not the best because all the bots have to go pick up all these purple chests and go deliver them around, which is not ideal. It's very far from the flyer to a storage chest. I think I was being a bit lazy when I set that up though. Could have definitely been a lot better. And I got all this uranium to process. I mean, these little Cobrex loops are pretty cool. quite funny how easy they can be. Like, you just prioritize the belt and then just keep in here, and then anything that gets out goes in here. So simple. Do 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 do. It's like little circle cogs, then a bigger circle cog. But I think I actually convert all my extra uranium into matter currently, because I need matter for oil and mineral water. I got this oil being printed. Yeah, but it looks like we're actually good. Just kind of curious. We've done 377,000 prints. Each print is 100 crude. So that's 32 million crude oil we've printed. That's quite a lot. 32 million. And this is not the most efficient recipe either. I haven't switched it to doing the heavy oil fracking. Which would make sense. I should do that. Because then I can do heavy oil to light oil. And then use that to make the rocket fuel. I think I would save a bit of resource too. Anyway, we were working on Maelstrom. And is the meta recipe even any good? When I looked at it, it just seems so expensive. Yeah, it does seem expensive. For me, what I'm doing is turning core overflow into matter and then using it to make the two liquids, because my delivery of liquids is too low for mineral water and oil for my needs. And I was trying to save UPS by doing the matter instead of doing like four spaceships for each resource type to move the fluids instead, because I've got a whole planet like core mining oil and core mining mineral water, and they're processing it off-site, but it's just too slow for my consumption. I just need so much resource. And these ones all been retired, these four. Let's sit here now, do nothing. But yeah, the mana recipe, you lose like one out of a thousand, so It's not too bad. It's not too good, but it's not too bad. I was a bit frowny on it initially because it does use these basic meta stabilizers. So you lose 100,000 of them, and so it's mainly just the cost of matter is, I think, it's a bit high still. Where's my matter? We got 11 million matter, which is fine. I think I had 14 million when I started using it again. And I still send barrels of gas into orbit, which is a bit sad. I mean, I need to convert this to being a train. I do have the a spare elevator here, and it's sort of just all it's doing is doing matter. Yeah, the matter is very expensive. I turned all of my uranium 238s excess, into matter, and then I got down here, I've got all the core mining getting converted to matter. So this is all overflowing core mining because I don't need this resource, so I might as well matter it. I mean, something's getting through. I haven't set up enough, but I was crushing it. But it's better now that I'm actually converting it. Hey, these new look at these arrows now. That's new. I haven't looked at my pumps since they changed that change. I saw there's a little patch notes about arrows. Hadn't noticed arrows before. So it shows all the arrows in and out on every item. Bit of a UI Doesn't look very clean on the UI though. Also we're good for stone. We're making landfill and then crushing it. But maybe we're converting that landfill, the stone into matter instead of crushing it to nothing. That was the old solution. I mean, these plants with the four, I only got efficiently three, but that even that's only 5 megawatts. It does rely on this though, these speed six, this the efficiency three combos. But yeah, I'm not like fully. I was fully relying on matter. I wasn't really doing core mining per se that much. Mostly I was just printing as I needed it. So I did set up, I got stone set up here as well from core mining, which is a bit sad because I'm making stone here, but also I'm crushing it at the other end, which is a bit stupid. Why is there a charged matter stabilizer in it? It's a bit strange. Yeah, so I really should be being more, bit more thoughtful of my stone. I shouldn't even be making this. What's the logic on it? Less than 10. Maybe I can add a stone logic on it as well. If stone is less than 6,000, I'll make it on this thing. So I stop eating it. I just tear it up. Really? You wouldn't use the matter plant? Never need stone when core mining. Oh, I've been short on stone for a while because all these new K2EC processors are very heavy on stone usage. I was a bit short of it. But I think it's balancing out again now. Now we're actually getting excess stone, so maybe it is fine. I mean, we are literally just deleting it here. And we've got a whole belt load of it coming out this way. This belt probably could do an upgrade. I think it's a bit too slow. I mean, going to 60 a second will help a little bit. I mean, that might help a little bit. Yeah, I need to add some logic so I don't make it. So this should go connect the stone. Is less than 4,000. There we go. Shouldn't make any more. Should be fine now. It'll just turn itself off. And use the belt stone instead. I didn't really buffer that much, but it should be enough that it feeds through into the network. As most of the stone is actually being used in here for things like quartz and silicon and stuff, and glass. Yeah, lots of glass, and then it all goes into making this. This is the main cost. All that is stone, basically. Glass and silicon, stone. Lithium is to stone. So only plastic, which is gas, isn't stone. We need shit tons of those components to make like these. Red chips. No, red chip seems fine actually, it's been pretty good for a long time. I'm still making wood here, I don't even know what I'm doing with it. I think it's just been turned into green chips. We don't actually don't need it though. I'm a little bit distracted tonight. I'm not really focused. Was working on Maelstrom. And I didn't realize I'd already done another planet that does core mining, so it was actually a waste of time. I set up this new core mining down here. I was going to dock a spaceship to it. We have got, oh my god, we do have biters. You're shitting me. Man, this game is so cheaty. So, back in 0.5, they introduced biter meteors, and this planet had zero biters on it. I was quite happy with that. But what I think's happened is when it regenerated the maps for 0.6, all the unknown areas generated biters. Even though I'd kept the planet clean of biters. Now I got biters on this planet. And I'm like, right, I'm gonna attack me really quickly. that's kind of annoying, but we can discard this and go. Maelstrom. Oh. And go. Autoclave. Wow, look at how fast it is. It's like kind of jumping around too. Well, that's pretty efficient. Yeah, I don't mind that. That's yeah, they're all gone. And this thing's like the edge of the star system too. Rather made the glaive more efficient. That's like jumping around smarter than it used to be. It used to like drag along. I can see this turning on and off. I didn't used to do that, so that's neat. I think that's it as far as the biters go. Oh, we found some more. Okay. This thing's gonna keep finding biters, I imagine. Yeah. Cool story, mate. Let's go wipe out biters forever. We don't mind. I need this iron core. The red jack. Now this is like the old design. I might use my new design. I could repurpose the existing ones that were doing mineral water, actually swap them to doing this instead. This is like a retrofitted cuckoo class, but the only thing I need to know is the ID numbers for the ships. And then I can copy onto the other ones. So this is just an ID 38 moon. Hey, I'm too tired. Yeah, at the time of the 0.5 though, it didn't generate biters when they did that change. So my planets were still biter free. And I put up heaps of defenses so no meteorites could get through. But at some point they've regenerated the biters in the dark zones. So then I'm like caught my pants down. Alright, we just need Moon 38. Well, not 38 actually, we're going to another planet, actually. We're going to Maelstrom. This is planet 29. So we're just gonna repurpose. Oh, look at this dead zone of the bots. Look at that trail of dead bots. Why do they keep going up to this thing? What are they doing? I don't know why they're moving up there, but why have we got a storage chest up there? Yeah, that's dumb. Historical me makes some dumb decisions, man. Just leave it off. That's fine. We've got these ships here in orbit. Now these ones have got stuff on them. Might just repurpose this one and rename it and make it a core miner. Now it's got the it's got the international, it's got the global logics, which is not so easy to convert. I've got a different one though. What's it called? Well, I thought I blueprinted it, but maybe I forgot. It's supposed to be the Cuckoo Class 9. I don't see it here. I thought I dumped it down here. There's some game blueprints. Oh yeah, there it is. There's a generic. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. This is inside Star System version, so I need this version. Let's go retrofit this ship. I'm just trying to delete all this and see what works. In theory that it will be good. Now we're going to planet, was it 38? I can't remember. We've got Maelstrom. Why do I remember 38? Weird difference. Anyway, we're gonna swap this being iron. What's that one? I think that's the only thing I've set. I think otherwise the ship is done. We've got the cargo. Why we got Right, we are a bit low on that, but that's fine. Oh, we need a docking logic as well. So currently it's set to dock. It's on. And it's ID 98, so it's set to dock to 68. So what's the Ophion ID number? Oh no, not the Ophion. Iron. Or what's your number, mate? Oh, come on. You're 62. Okay, so let's go Dr. 62. Then we'll be good. We'll share this docking clamp. So 62 of 98. Minus 36 on this. Sync it up. I think we're good. Oh, we've got this as well. It changes to iron ore. Iron ore. And it's got building materials on it too. Alright, I think we're good to go. What's, is it turned off? No, it's not turned off. It's just, what's it missing? It doesn't have much steam. I think I'll risk it. We'll go to Maelstrom. It Shit, what was that number? I can't remember what number ship that was. It was this one. Rename it as well. Iron core. Cool. That's been repurposed. Should be fine. I could retrofit the haulers again, I think. I don't know. I really like the logic they've got, though. I've kind of simplified it for this, where to set the one thing. I would like it that if these two were set as well, but if these were a generic signal, so that was like a B signal or something. Or I can just send this through as a B. Things have to do a B times 1200 though, to get that through there as a B 1200. Oh, would I? Nah, it's probably fine I sent it, because otherwise you have to convert all these storage things here. Well, so it does have to go through the Astro Belt, but it does go quite fast, because we do have three shields, so it's not too bad. I don't remember what this logic was either. Be quite good there. Got 150 Logibots. Oh my god, what's happened here? Well, that's not good. That's not good at all. What have I done? Got 2300 construction bots on this. I think the problem is I've kind of tried to be cheap, having one chest. But it should be in two chests. Each chest is like, you know, 24 extra weight. So I probably should have remove this. And a chest here. And they'll do. It's not such a nightmare anymore. So I let that get into it. Well, it means I can update the blueprint a little bit, but that's not too bad. We can fix this. It'll be fine. But when it gets to Maelstrom, I have a dock, so I don't even know if I don't even check if it can dock. What's the dock here? Oh, there's no spaceship clamps, really? What? How's that possible? There was a clamp. I swear there was. No clamp on the ground, either. Okay. Strange. Alright, we'll just clear some trees anyway. Gonna be a bad person. Where's the power? Alright, that ship's not gonna land. I have to tell it to land it myself. That's the 98. Anchor. I think there, but I can't tell these dockings. Like, we go. I think it should be like plumb. But muffin dock there. Okay, with the trees, no. Just anchor. And now it's got the clamp. And that should be a 62, right? Alright, take off the launch condition. gonna check this out. So what's the number? Is it 62? Cool, so that's all good. The only problem is it's loading left to right. It should be loading on this right hand side. What's worth doing? Is this too fast? It is 30 a second. It is actually too fast for these red belts. These insetters. These insetters can do, I think, 39 a second. It's like almost perfect. But the problem is the belt speed is only 30 a second. But this actually saturates more than a belt. We can't unload it fast enough. Yeah, I could tap another scene. They're very far apart though. There's one over there, one up there. The main ones are way down here. I was just trying to avoid getting to them. I was just trying to be cheap by doing one seam. There are no belts or something. Because we've got 3,000 core fragments here. Pretty good. Thousands of recannons. Where's my belt production though? We got no red belts. Fast. We got 69 fast belts. Bit sad. Is it ready to launch? Let's have a look. Yes it is. So it's got it's filled up. Now it's requesting 17,000. I think I realised it was these ones. These ones here holding. That's part of the flawed logic of my design. Now it's 960. But why isn't it filling it up? It's already filled this one up though. Ah, it's because I'm loading. Yeah, so the whole idea of loading right to left is that this is the last one to get items. But this just means that these ones get it sooner. First we put crushes on each side of the initial box though. They have no trouble keeping it once beaconed. Oh yeah. Then you're gonna ship more items though. You're gonna ship iron ore, stone, and cores. I can see it being better though, but yeah. You have to move up more physical items. This is, I actually need a strong box for this. I don't think I make strong boxes here. No, I don't. Yeah, but you have a ship carrier, so it's only more item types. Well, yeah, I got a ship carrier, but it's got limited slots, right? So I'm carrying more things. It's more about the, are the item stacks better when it's uncompressed? Maybe they are. I mean, I still got normal cores, which would be annoying, but the iron ore would be compressed better, and so would the stone. So I haven't done the math on having three item types. I mean, you kind of get like 1-to-1 on the core, stone, iron ore core to normal cores, like almost 1-to-1 after productivity. If not worse. But maybe it's okay. We need this thing. I mean, I do have the cores and the stone on my, like, fluid ships. Liquid crushers. Not the crush, not those crushers. Pulverizers, that's right. I think about two times the mount for dedicated cores and three to four times on the Nelms cores. Yeah, so say I crush iron ore here, right? I get like, you know, that's... I mean, that stacks way better, right? That stacks heaps better, the iron ore versus the actual ore fragment. Whereas that stacks like shit, and that stacks really good too. So I think overall, from this, you'd actually stack a lot better by crushing it and shipping the iron ore instead. I mean, ideally you'd actually go all the way to ingots and ship ingots. I mean, you just do the all the processing here. And that, I just wanted to... This is like one of the few cores I hadn't rehooked up, that's all. So I was like, just rehooking up first before I start decentralizing it. Because I need the ships going first. But yeah, you get those ingots, like, so good. You get 50 ingots, 500 plates. The crazy mad recipe ratio. But getting like... if I do this, I need pyroflux barrels shipped. Which might be a little annoying. The core fragment processing here, it's you just don't get much of actual the normal cores. It's mostly all just iron. So it's not too bad. I was thinking you were lazy and only did the first step. Yeah, I mean, there's different optimals. I think all my planets were originally just doing the one step, send cores to Nelvis and processing, but that's when the cores were five times denser. So I've been slowly decentralizing and off-world processing. I've got Bits of Lunge, Cryonite, and another one, Vulcanite, off-worlded. Can of the Vulcanite blocks. That's what I used to do actually. Maybe I should get back into doing that. So I have, this is my Vulcanite world. And I started making the, you know, Vulcanite blocks here. We got like kind of filled up. Wonder why it stopped though. This is running out of crushed Vulcanite, but I think it's a lie. Why is it not just filled up with crushed Vulcanite? Okay. Whatever. I think it's because I've set it to not really go. Yeah, so this planet used to do all the Vulcanite block sending to different planets here, but I haven't set that up again. So I really need to hook this back up. Because all the deliveries are ready to go, okay. That's how I used to do it, so there's no reason I can't carry on doing this again. And add a few... I have to add it to every planet that does its own smelting, I guess. It doesn't make sense. Yeah, it did make a lot of... Well, these are stacks of 100 solid rocket fuel before they change the stack sizes. I mean, they can't make these, they can't make any more. They used to make it from Vulcanite blocks. But that's all long gone. So these were for the Vulcanite blocks, but they must have delivered it all and then I ran out. Yeah, adding a cannon per planet is pretty low overhead. Yeah. But, delivery cans I find very optimal for certain items. Not all items, but yeah, certain items are really good for it. Oh, I went a bit too far. I'm gonna jump over that. I don't think that's very feasible. I mean, I set this up a while ago, but I just didn't, get it fully going. Is it going left or right? Go right to left. Left to let's go the other way around. Cool. That should put blocks. I'm a bit lazy here, but that's blocks. This plant can keep making them. Not the most efficient setup, but I don't need many of them, so once it gets going, it should be pretty good. That should fill those storage chests up at least. But I think they'll get cannoned out. I really wish my science wasn't dead though. I don't know what's happened. I suspect. Oh, turn that one off. I suspect. Oh, once this is filled up, we put on plates. Why isn't it the rocket going then? This is ready. It's loading cargo. Why isn't it? Is this a me problem? I see what's happened. It's like at the perfect don't launch situation, I think. Oh no, we've got 20,000 orbit. So what's happened to my science then? I thought it was Naquitite holding me back, but it's not. Those cubes have run out. I want 100 cubes, but no cubes. Cubes are wanting vulcanite block. Oh, we've run out of vulcanite block. Are you crazy? Really? I want 10 vulcanite block and I got 0. Weird. Okay. So now I ran out of vulcanite block in orbit, but we got 0 up here. Maybe it was getting delivered from the other planet, actually, and I just ran out, and hasn't been delivering it. I don't think it's even on my, list here. This is my shopping list. I'm gonna go add vulcanite block of, 2000. That should get added to my rocket that goes up. This generic rocket should, well, it's kind of, maybe 150 was a good number after all. Change that number up to higher. Yes, I really like this change I did to my, generic rocket. So I've got, I've got number ranges. Well, this is 0 to 50. And then I have that filter into the request and also to the, filters. And so it doesn't. I was finding when I had all of them requesting, it kind of like be a bit manic and flood a bit. But now we've got different number ranges. It seems to work out better. So currently these bottom ones should be requesting these vulcanite blocks because that's where there were shortages. But weirdly it's requesting it here as well. At the 100 mark. Oh yeah, because it's no, it shouldn't be requesting. If I can do it up wrong. Oh, they're not connected at all. No, there. We can take that one. It's not passing anything through, so how can it request it? That's weird. Not sure what I did wrong there, but, oh, maybe it's a sick signal. Oh, yeah, I've got a grain equal to 100 signal going through as well. There's an extra signal. Which means that anything... Oh, yeah, it's kind of like an override one. That's fine, so I got two layers of thing going on, so... These will get Vulcanite block loaded on. So it doesn't seem to be inserting on these ones. Look at Vulcanite block, but then these have not got requests on it. Oh, this thing was 3k. Really? I've got a max? Oh, okay, so I never request him. We'll just do one stupid number. And we'll at least request some blocks. It took a long time to load that up though. Three of them's a bit better. It's all the high dense stuff I need. Yeah, science is going again, so I think that cannons are going from Ain as well. Is crafting more? It seems to be I thought this wouldn't lock up, but it seems to be... I've set this to 3k, right, on the enriched. Problems won't make blocks. I'm gonna change that number. What are these ones at? I don't give a shit. Enabled of less than equal to. A 1,000 then. Oh wait, it won't go at all, will it? Because, 3,600. The problem there is actually the storage chest size. What's the size? What's that? What's that's 500 per lane, right? So it's 1,000 there. Change these to 1,000. But it's not going to work until we clear out the existing. It's kind of annoying. So I have to make it like a dumb number for now. Just to make them go. Once it cleans it out, it should be okay. I don't know where the other ones are hiding though. It says there's 2400 there, but where's the other 1200? Are they in these chests? Oh, they are. Overflows, I see. Anyway, this should start going again. Because... I'll do 500 of both of these. Ah, oh, she's filtered though. Really need more crushes though. I mean, this one is probably insufficient. We should have multiple. I was being a bit bare bones setting that up. Anyway, these things should be delivering to other planets that need it. So they did their job though, they delivered to Nava, so. Huh, the old logic where we have overflow logic. That should be actually set to zero, these should be. This is before I learned that logic. These are very old setups. Here we go. So funny, I thought I had no Naquitite plate. I thought my science was busted from that, but actually no, it was just a vulcanite block. Alright, how's the new ship going then? Yeah, so doing that, the iron ore, probably is a good thing. Now, doing the next step, you need sulfuric acid, and to get sulfuric acid, you need sulfur. That's a little annoying, that step. You do need a lot of acid. Now, we do have 25,000 acid currently, and we do have, I think, decent. I mean, we didn't have any before. I started doing some gas. Looks like we got a lot of gas now. I set this up last time. I deliver coal capsules, and I make all the gas out of it, which seems to be working. We seem to be getting decent amount of sulfur now. So I could go to processing it here and making ingots, and then I ship ingots back instead. Or I don't even have a spaceship. I just do delivery capsule. Delivery. Or I can make it like an actual iron world where I just send the ingots here to every other planet that needs it. But I still think you should centralize where you send it from. So you kind of move the main bulk of the resource to one place, and then from there it spreads it out. Even though it's an extra step, I think it's still easier because you better make more delivery cannons at that location. Though this seems to be okay on delivery cannons now. There wasn't many before, but now we've got thousands. Not literally. So it's back in business, it looks like. You've got my old inserters go. Oh, what are these modules? So this is the efficiency 1. Oh, there's copper wire now. And there's glass. And it needs solid fuel. I'm getting the yawns, so I might go raids on. Very short stream. I only do like 2 to it, 2.5. Sometimes up to 4, but pretty tired this week. It looks like my ship is good, so it's like a mild success. I'll just flick it on. You can do its thing. The main thing is, as long as these chests are why is it storing that in there? Yeah, there shouldn't be storage chests. There should be passive fighters. Yeah, I think the setup's okay. We don't have too many bots idling. The coal miner's like dead. But that's because, you know, we don't have enough storage. Even with that's gonna like 32 storage. I think the spaceship is at 24, so it's still more than the whole spaceship. But I could just like, the other thing I can do is just literally just turn, I could crush it here, like all of it, and turn it, like, well not all of it, just crush it and get rid of the stone and the iron ore and turn it into matter. And then have a matter pickup. Let's pick up matter instead. I mean that might be better. I don't know. Anyway. Who's doing Factorio? Who do we go to? The goss on that. I mean, we can go to T-Hex, who's doing Oni. I think Factorio. Oh, Herland. A new. Space Pug. Dirt Dave doing SpaceX, First World. I kind of like rating SpaceX players. I got Andy Gaming as well. He's streaming. I'll try a new person. Dirt Dave. I would prefer doing T-Hex though. But they're not doing Factorio. So thanks for watching, thanks for the raid, ECF Hobbit, and thanks for chats, Regathian. GG.